When you talk about the new manifesto, we have to also look about the old manifesto and the context in which it was written. If you go back to the global context, we still talked about the new economic order. And the people who talked about new economic order, Hans Singer was one of them, and he was preparing his manifesto. And they realized that even if colonialism was not there anymore, as political system, the colonial economic order still existed. And how this existed, one of the major, in fact, the major factor of this existence was technological capability. It gives you power, and that power you use to maintain the colonial order. So they came out with many suggestions, and one of them was that developing countries get technological capability to change the system. The system was unequal, and any unequal system cannot be corrected with innovations generated within the system. That new innovation has to come from outside, some external intervention has to be there to create an innovation which can disturb that system. So that's why it was important in the manifesto that developing countries, the governments take responsibility of promoting innovation. But now things have changed. We're no longer talking about new international economic order. The governments are taking very similar policies after Washington consensus and neoliberal economics. So what we have is, even in our countries, we talk about private sector driven innovation. Now we're in the same system now. Now can this technology that we could develop challenge the system? If you look at, you might get consolation of the fact that in countries like India, the expenditure on R&D has gone up very significantly. But what kind of innovation they created, especially in the private sector? I can talk about many, I cannot get into details, but today we have technology which has been marketed in the West but not yet in the country. Now this is what innovation we have created now. Now this is one angle of the story. Now you come to, what kind of innovation you create. The kind of public policy, the kind of government policy you make is very, very important. In the government policy, you so-called talk about the best practices in the world, and people talk about best practices. There are two issues with the best practice. One, that you cannot have best practice for all situations. And secondly, the best practice you talk about, the practices possibly will accept that, the known till now. There can be innovation in practices which might be much better. That is being denied. Countries should have right to make mistakes in the process of innovation, the process of experiments and the truth, but countries are being denied that opportunity. So as a result, even if we get into that, we are not going to change any systemic change. We will create tinkering around here and there. The grassroots innovation we're talking about, as long as they remain grassroots and they remain very small in measure, it's fine. But if they try to create a disruptive impact, I'm sure they're not going to succeed.